For those of you who want to build a great product, this video is made for you. I will break down my UX design workflow. I break down this entire workflow to three parts so that it's easy to understand. The first stage is pre-figma stage. The second stage is heavy-figma stage. And the third stage is light-figma stage. And let's start from the beginning. Pre-figma stage is everything you need to do for preparation before jumping to the Figma file and then design the screens. And this stage includes syncing with PMs, engineers, or if you are in a startup, the founders of the startup, do user interview, create persona, map out the current user journey, and then design a user journey for your product, and internal iterations. Engineering and product sync can happen anywhere at this stage. The main idea is to get product constraints and engineering constraints early on, so you don't design for a solution that will never be able to implement at your company. User interview pretty much just means understand the problem and understand the user before jumping into creating a solution for them. Most companies are solving a problem that doesn't even exist. So defining the right problem at this stage and making sure that problem actually exists, it's super important for anyone in your company to do a good job. And I think that's usually the founder's responsibility and the PM's responsibility. So make sure you collaborate with them. And if you think there's things that's not working, tell them your feedback. Persona, well, there's so many examples of persona. All you need to do is to create a character that represents your target user. And then you can reference to that persona's name throughout the design process. The next one, I feel like a lot of companies skipping this step, which is mapping out the current user journey. You can simply go on Google Doc or Notion, just type down every single step the user has to do to solve the problem today. You can use arrows to connect each step, and then you can explain each step further in detail. After you map out the current user journey, you need to propose the after user journey, and that one is the user journey for your product. The idea is that you need to create a user experience that's better than what the user already have today. Many designers jump directly to designing the screens without thinking through how do I build a good UX framework. And unfortunately, no UI can compensate for a bad UX. Let me give you a concrete example. Let's say one day I decide to become a UX design tutor. If one day I have too many students coming in, I will want to design a product that's digital. At this stage, I hire some UX designers and engineers to build me a website that can just simplify all the process, bring the service online. It's extremely important for you to map out the existing user journey. In the beginning, there's a stage where I have this one-on-one conversation with the student that I share my story, she shares her story, and this stage builds trust. If we skip the user journey step, you might see a designer bring me a flow that looks like a website landing page that directly wants to sell you this course. It may not build the amount of trust that I was building before, and it may not build the amount of human connection I was building before. To design a product that the user will actually adapt to, you have to think through what's happening before and at least design something that is as good as what's happening before. So maybe after mapping out the user journey, you realize it's much better to bring a video of me talking about the product so the user sees my face, knows who I am, and understands my story, and then later on ask the user to tell their story in a creative way. And finally, for pre-Figma stage, you need to go through internal iteration. I will just make this user journey brainstorming session a team collaboration session. I will invite engineers, I will invite PMs, I will invite the founder for this startup, if it's a startup. And that helps everyone to get an idea of what we're going to build. That can also help with directly understand the constraints from the product and engineering side. So we just solve that problem in the meeting. Now going to heavy Figma stage. This stage includes you as a designer designing all the screens, designing everything. The biggest mistake you can make at this stage is jumping right into designing a high fidelity prototype. So ideally, you shall go from wireframe or low fidelity prototype to user testing, to mid fidelity prototype, to another user testing, then to high fidelity prototype. Your wireframe shall represent your proposed user journey in the previous step, but there's no need to worry about color, font sizes, font spacings. Just put the text in without any auto layout and then just use gray color. Don't try to make this pretty. And ideally, you should be bringing this wireframe to some users to test out whether the structure makes sense. However, I understand that many companies will tell you we don't have the resources to bring user testing this early. Then I would suggest you find people inside your company that actually use your product and then test these on them. I don't suggest to iterate on your design only based on what your boss say to you or only based on what the leadership tells you. They will bring more feedback from a product-oriented and business-oriented point of view, which might not lead to best design that's for your user. You want a balance. After this user testing, then we can go to meet-fi prototype. And how many details to add into this meet-fi prototype is really based on your decision. So after meet-fi prototype, we shall bring this to another round of user testing. Basically, we have to have at least one round of user testing before we bring the product to the engineers. And usually, the early we bring in user testing, the more money we're going to save. Let's say if you've never done any user testing before meet-fi prototype, and if at this stage your user tells you that the structure just doesn't make sense, then you will have to go all the way back to the low fidelity prototype and then change all the structure there. So finally, after this user testing, you shall go to high fidelity prototype, or you can do more iterations based on the timeline of your company. This one should be in sync with your current design system. All the spacings, all the details shall be spot on and align with the other designs in your company. Finally, it is the Light-figma stage. The Light-figma stage is what happens after you ship your design. Just because shipping your design doesn't mean your design stops here, because the engineers can bring you a 1,000 requests after you ship your design. It's just a simple fact that front-end engineering doesn't work the same way as designing on Figma. Thinking through the user point of view doesn't mean we can think through all the scenarios a code can return. One example, if you're designing for a responsive website, then you have to work with a front-end engineer to make sure that the responsive actually looks good to you. You might need to adjust your design a little bit just for the front-end code to work. And for back-end scenarios, there could be error cases that you forgot to design for. Every single interaction point in your design could return an error in the back-end, and you need to think about maybe a pop-up window that communicates what is the error and how to fix it for the user. That's something I forgot to design last time. There could be also other things like the legal coming to you and say that, oh, you have to change this text of line because this just won't work in the EU. Yeah, Europe has a lot of laws regarding how your product needs to communicate itself. So you might need to adjust your product because of the legal reason. In the Light-figma stage might not be super light on Figma after all. So I really think it's much more healthier to think of all these three stages equally instead of only focusing on the heavy Figma stage. I hope if you're trying to build a great product, this video is insightful to you. And if you want to see any other thing from my channel, just drop me a comment. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. I'm Aliana, and see you next time.